We now have some sense of how we can make lighting calculations not take an incredible amount of time. In this lesson, we're going to take an extremely high-level view of how objects get rendered by a graphics accelerator. This graphics hardware is usually called the GPU, for Graphics Processing Unit. A GPU uses a rendering process called rasterization, or scan conversion, which is optimized to use the simplifications I've outlined. Let's look at one rendering pipeline from end to end. The idea of a pipeline is to treat each object separately. The first step is simply that the application sends objects to the GPU. What objects? Typically 3D triangles. Each triangle is defined by the locations of its 3 points. An application converts a cube into just a few triangles. A sphere gets turned into a bunch of triangles. So, in the first step, the application decides what triangles to send down the pipeline. In the second stage of the pipeline, these triangles are modified by the camera's view of the world, along with whatever modeling transform is applied. A modeling transform is a way to modify the location, orientation, and even the size of a part. For example, if you were rendering a bouncing ball, the ball's modeling transform each frame would move the ball to a different location along its path. The effect of the camera view is clear enough. After the object is moved to its location for the frame, is it still in view of the camera? That is the object inside the view frustum? If not, then we're done with this object, since it won't affect any pixels on the screen. In this case, we say the object was fully clipped. So here, this cube is fully clipped, since it's outside of the view frustum. The camera and modeling transforms compute the location of each triangle on the screen. If the triangle is partially or fully inside the frustum, the 3 points of the triangle on the screen are then used in a process called rasterization. If a triangle is slightly off the screen, it gets clipped and is turned into more triangles. This process identifies all the pixels whose centers are inside the triangle. In other words, it fills in the triangle. So rasterization here has found that this triangle covers the pixel centers in these various places. These locations are then used to show the image of the triangle on the screen.